ॐ सहनावतु सहनो भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधितमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिः शान्तिः शान्तिः। ओम मे ही प्रोटेक्ट अस बोथ टीचर एंड स्टूडेंट्स टुगेदर, मे ही नरिश अस बोथ टुगेदर, मे वी वर्क कंजॉइंटली विद ग्रेट एनर्जी, मे आवर स्टडीज बी विगरस एंड इफेक्टिव, मे वी नॉट म्यूचुअली डिस्प्यूट और मे वी नॉट हेट एनी। ओम लेट देयर बी पीस इन मी, let there be peace in my environment and let there be peace in the forces that act on me. Cubitus varus or the Gunstock deformity. Dear students, today we are going to discuss the cubitus varus or the Gunstock deformity, the commonest complication of the supracondylar fracture humerus in children. And then in brief about the flexion type of the supracondylar fracture we'll be discussing. Now the discussion on this Gunstock deformity will be done on the following points. One, the three static deformities of cubitus varus. Two, pathomechanics. Three, the clinical tests. Four, radiographs. Five, treatment including the French osteotomy and the King's osteotomy and derotation osteotomy. 6. Quick facts about the cubitus varus. Now, the cubitus varus or Gunstock elbow is called so called because the deformity, it resembles like a rifle gunstock. You just look at the second picture there. Look at here how this particular deformity is very much similar to the rifle gun stock. And this is the most common complication in the supracondylar fractures. The incidence varies from 9 to 58%. The deformity becomes obvious in extended elbow. So as you can see here, after extending on the left side, the gun stock deformity is visible. Now there are three static deformities of the cubitus varus, and all these deformities are described with respect to the distal fragment. So the first deformity is there is a posterior displacement of the distal fragment. Then second deformity is there is a horizontal rotation of the distal fragment, and of course there is a coronal tilt. Now there are four important causes for the Gunstock deformity, and they include four I's. So first I is improper person treating. Second I is improper reduction. Third I, improper interpretation of the radiograph. And fourth I, improper follow-up. Coming to the pathomechanics of the Gunstock deformity, posterior displacement of the horizontal and horizontal rotation predisposes to the coronal tilt because the edges of the fracture fragments are thin. There is very little resistance to the coronal tilt if the fragments are horizontally rotated, and the contraction of biceps produces the medial tilting force. Now all these three components should be corrected during the initial reduction of the fracture. Otherwise, cubitus varus deformity results. Now, determination of the quality of the fracture reduction after the initial injury can be assessed by the following clinical radiological test. So, as you see here in the first picture, the long axis of the forearm and long axis of the humerus should be parallel when the elbow is flexed after the reduction. The same thing is seen here, the long axis of the forearm and the arm is parallel. And this is what is seen here in the lateral. The shoot through Jones view, again you can see the humerus and forearm bones, they are parallel. So the first clinical test is after reduction, when you flex the elbow, hyperflex the elbow, the long axis of the forearm and humerus should be parallel in the same line when the elbow is flexed after reduction. Now in AP view, now the AP view is taken using a Jones view, because once you are hyperflexed, it is that particular view also known as shoot through view. Here the Bowman angle should be less than 5 degrees and it should be same as opposite uninjured side. So you have to take both the x-rays. In lateral view, all the normal radiological signs must be restored. For example, we had already talked in my last video regarding the anterior humeral line, the coronoid line and the inclination of the lateral humeral condyle and the teardrop sign and the fat pads and like that. So all those parameters must be normal. And if the clinical radiological criteria are satisfactory after the close reduction, then only the close reduction is accepted. Otherwise, the re-reduction is attempted. And ignoring these criteria after close reduction often results into the future cubitus varus deformity. That we must understand. Now coming to the treatment part of cubitus varus, we must realize that cubitus varus is only a cosmetic deformity with no functional impairment of the elbow. And hence the treatment of choice is always a corrective osteotomy, but surgery is deferred until the skeletal maturity is achieved, as cosmesis gains importance at that age. And if you do the corrective osteotomy before maturity, there is a fear of recurrence of deformity. The methods utilized for correction of the deformity include the French and modified French osteotomy. This is nothing but a lateral close based osteotomy. This operation is simple and easy to perform, and the posterior tricep splitting approach is used. As you can see in these particular diagrams here, the osteotomy is done between the two screws. Now the first screw is being placed anteriorly in the distal fragment. You can see the anteriorly, this is the anterior part, the anteriorly the screw is placed, and the second screw is placed posteriorly in the proximal fragment. Now after the osteotomy, the distal fragment is rotated such that both the screws become in one line parallel to each other, indicating the correction of rotational osteotomy, rotational deformity. Now a vase of bone is resected from the lateral cortex and the gap is closed, and a figure of 8 stainless steel wire secures both the screws against each other. Now this way the cubitus varus gets corrected. Then you may even try putting the transfixing K wires as well. The King's osteotomy, however, is a medial open vase osteotomy. This is opposite to the lateral closed vase osteotomy. In this, a vase of bone is inserted on the medial aspect after opening the osteotomy and the deformity is corrected. The derotation osteotomy, this technique is not as popular as the lateral closed or the medial open vase osteotomies mentioned above. To sum up the treatment facts of the cubitus varus, we must realize that cubitus varus is a cosmetic problem, not a functional. And hence, before skeletal maturity, the treatment is observation. Cosmetic considerations are not very important before 18 years of the age. And if surgically corrected, there is a chance that the deformity may recur. After the skeletal maturity, there is no further growth left. And hence, the recurrence chances are nil. The girls and boys are more cosmetically concerned at that particular age, and hence the corrective osteotomy is to be performed. Now coming to the second topic today, the flexion type of supraphundylar fractures. This is extremely rare, and an incidence is only 2.5%. Now you can see here in this particular x-ray, instead of distal fragment going posteriorly, it has come anteriorly, it is flexed. So that is why it is a flexion type. And the mechanism of injury, you fall, see there is a direct force acting on the point of this elbow. The common method of injury is the direct blow to the posterior aspect of the arm. Now, angulation is seen in the lateral radiography is reverse of the extension type, right? And the fracture is associated with high incidence of ulnar nerve injury. The treatment, close reduction and immobilization in above elbow plaster cast in extension is undesirable, as it causes elbow stiffness. And hence, to overcome this, Sultanpur's technique is used. Now, if the reduction can be achieved by closed methods, then the fracture can be stabilized in flexion with percutaneous pins. If reduction cannot be achieved, then the open reduction and internal fixation is contemplated. Now, what is this Sultanpur's technique? Sultanpur described by the Sultanpur of Behrin. Now, in this particular technique, it helps to immobilize the flexion type of supramedullary fractures in flexion rather than in conventional extension. Now, it is a two-stage procedure. In the first stage, what do they do? The cast is put until the distal end of the proximal fragment. Now, you can see here in this particular diagram, that this is the arm, this is the forearm, the cast is applied up to the distal end of the proximal fragment and is allowed to set. And then next, the distal fragment is pushed back against this cast. Now they put a rolled towel underneath that cast applied, and now they are pushing the distal fragment posteriorly, and thus the reduction is achieved. You can see here how first the cast is applied up to this place, once the cast is set, then this is pushed back and we achieve the reduction. The cast is then completed with elbow inflection, and this is what the Sultanpur's technique used for flexion type of supraphundylar fracture humerus. Then there are certain complications. The injury to the ulnar nerve is common in this type of fracture. And second important complication is loss of elbow flexion. This is another important complication commonly encountered in flexion type of supramedullary fracture humerus. Now, before we end, I want to talk to you about one more important topic. That is happy key to lose weight. Dear students, one of the commonest problems we are facing in our routine clinical orthopedic practice is that of obesity. Now, eat less and exercise more formula has been proved to be the failed formula for the treatment of obesity. Of late, I have been working on the latest, the most scientific, evidence-based concept of weight loss, happy key. Now, you may find few videos on this topic as well on this YouTube channel. The obesity among the medical student is at its peak nowadays. I have seen so many medical students very hefty, obese in my class. Due to obesity, not only they are bullied, but most of them also lose their self-confidence, resulting into deteriorating performance in the academics. Now, for all of them, this online video course will be most valuable. If interested, you may visit my Facebook page on https://www.facebook.com/thehappykey. You can also visit my website www.docorsudhir.com. I host regular webinar for the same twice a week, Wednesday and Friday at 8 p.m. On Sundays, 1 p.m. Now, you may join those webinars to know the details, follow using the following link, https://zoom.us/j/82794043 08. My mission is to help more than 10 lakh persons to lose weight and get lifetime freedom from their obesity without dieting and exercising using this Happy Key technique. Let us all come together to create a healthy, fit India. Thank you. Thank you for subscribing my channel. See you in my next video.